And a powerful nor'easter swept through the Northeast overnight, hitting some 70 million people. For many, it's the biggest storm they've seen in years. CBS's Tom Hansen is in Times Square with details on how the damage it caused and how the coronavirus pandemic has affected preparations.
Paramedics in western Pennsylvania were checking on a minor accident when a truck narrowly missed everyone after losing control on the snowy road. The storm knocked out power to thousands and caused hundreds of accidents up and down the East Coast.
If you don't need to be out, stay home. Presently, I'm on the scene of a 19-car collision.
For many, this also was the first heavy snowfall since the coronavirus pandemic began.
I've been in my apartment for like 7 months now, so what's another day?
Here in New York City, indoor dining is shut down to slow the spread of the virus. Many restaurants have outdoor setups that snowplow truck drivers have been trained to work around.
So our operators are going to go very slowly, very methodically, and do their best to control speed.
The city received more snow from this storm than all of last winter.
I didn't think it was going to come down. It's crazy.
Schools here will be doing remote learning today, but many others are taking the snow day. Jefferson County, West Virginia schools emailed parents to say, this is one thing our kids won't lose this year. Children in West Philadelphia didn't waste the opportunity to play last night.
Fun by going down like the hill, and it was amazing.
State and local officials say they've made adjustments to ensure shipments of the coronavirus vaccine continue despite the storm. Tom Hansen, CBS News, New York.
And Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar said he is confident UPS and FedEx know how to handle winter storms, and he has staffers in place to help receive the shipments. And COVID-19 has become the leading cause of death in the U.S. That's according to a new study from Virginia Commonwealth University. Researchers found that by October, coronavirus had become the third leading cause of death among adults between 45 and 84, and for the second for people over 85. But since then, the daily death toll has tripled, and the virus is now the country's number one killer. To put it in perspective, about 1,700 Americans die from heart disease every day, 1,600 die from cancer, and over 2,400 die from COVID-19. The researchers say the daily COVID mortality rate is equivalent to lives lost in the September 11th attacks, occurring every day and a half. And coming up on Valley News Live at 4, it's a timely twist on a holiday tradition. We'll tell you why pandemic-themed ornaments for Christmas trees are selling out next.